Herr Bumbagai.
I filled my water bottle with carbonated water, and I'm afraid to open it.
Okay, it was making a weird noise earlier, so...
So first off, I took this tiny bottle-lit plop sound and played around with the pitch a lot. And it actually sounds pretty nice. In the finished track, I used these sounds as my kicks and snares, given the proper processing treatment, that being equalization, distortion and so on. Then I took a tiny fragment of those sounds and made it even shorter, which I then turned into this little rhythmic percussion clicky wicky noise, which sounds somewhat like this. And this. Then I took the original recording again and boosted the incredibly quiet background noise into more audible levels. And then I stretched and repitched the noise with all kinds of weird and totally abstract algorithms to create this metallic sounding noise. If you let this sound decay over a short amount of time, you've got yourself some nice cymbals. And obviously I also reversed some of those. If you slap a bandpass filter on the white noise, you can let only a tiny, literal band of frequencies pass through. If you now automate the position of this band, you've got yourself a little tonal riser. And now we get to the fun stuff. I took a tiny, minuscule chop of the bottle lid opening and repeated it like a bazillion times a second. This creates a constant tone that I further processed by taking away the signal at certain intervals and distorting the waveform a bit. In combination with some reverb and some other little effects, this sound makes a really good, cute-sounding lead instrument. In some parts, I found out that if you stack notes in a certain way, it kind of sounds like those stupid little beavers from Donkey Kong 64, and that made me laugh a lot, so I kept it in. And then there's this little pad, which is just the lead but played in chords and with more reverb and delay. You can also hear a lot of reversed and repitched versions of this pad throughout the track, which I just slapped everywhere to fill some gaps and keep the mood dreamy and soft. And lastly, the bass is the exact same pulsing sound I made, but layered with the noise we used earlier to make it sound really dirty and thick. So here's the full and finished track. I hope you enjoy it. If you enjoyed this video, consider sharing it with your friends or becoming a patron on patreon.com/wangeline to keep the channel alive or something. Huge thanks to all my current patrons, That's My Jam, Fan Carter, Scott Hadef, Chant Magic, Key Catty, Jacob Dias, Sora and Forenza Audio for your lovely support, and thank you very much. I'll see you next time when I make music with communalism. Bye.